You know, fellas, and the ladies, I know it's a couple of you out there listening. But no, when it comes to who you follow on YouTube, like, you know, myself being a content creator with a very small platform, I realize that it kind of makes me feel like I shouldn't, I don't want to say judge, but like I don't have the right to critique other content creators that have bigger platforms than I do. Like, you know, with all this red pill content being, you know, jumbled into like a beef stew, so to speak, you got the guys, basically, the divide for me is if a guy is trying to sell me anything. I don't mean trying to sell me his philosophy. I mean trying to commerce me into purchasing something from him that can better my life, which is really the only thing these guys are really good. They're doing, they're giving, some are giving some financial advice, but most of these men are after advice to conquer women, right? And see, that's not red pill. That's what you call purple pill. Like, okay, I'll just go ahead and talk about him now. Like Donovan Sharp, he talked about MGTOW, saying we were incels, we were lazy, and I'm not one of those MGTOW dudes. I got a like six pack abs and everything else, and a good job and everything else. Fairly good looking guy, intelligent. So I'm not one of them MGTOW guys that's forced to be a MGTOW guy because he can't get women. Like, even though I'll never show my face, you can look at me and see that I've had opportunities with women. You just look at me and tell. Just like you'd be able to look at me and tell that I'm not a fag boy because I'm MGTOW. Oh, you must be gay. You know, the shaming language that the women like to come up with. No, not at all. But, you know, what kind of made me think Donovan Sharp is kind of like a clown? First of all, he dissed MGTOW, and then he had two MGTOW dudes on his show, which basically made his ratings go up. I'll talk about that in a minute. But he got on a live stream one time, Donovan Sharp did, and he talked about how he was going to be going out with his girlfriend. He got a white girl that I'm pretty sure is a mud shark. And, you know, I personally don't want a mud shark. I don't want a white chick that a lot of niggas done had. Because if she done dealt with a lot of niggas, she's like a black woman, which is the very same woman that I'm trying to avoid. So, no. Like the Nala girls of the world? No. But anyway. So he's talking about, he pulls out these clear plastic pumps. Talking about, yeah, Devin's going to wear these tonight. And when she comes back, she's going to have this thong on. And right before she gives me fellatio, except he was vulgar with it. And I'm like, dog, you talk like that in an earshot of your girl to your buddies? I mean, that's the kind of shit I did in high school. And that was whack. It's like, yo, dude, like, I'm not going to be psyched on the dude because he gets sex, no matter what level of sex I'm getting. And right now, I'm not getting none. But I'm not going to be psyched on some dude because he's talking about what he's going to be doing with his girlfriend. Dude, I don't care about what you do with your girlfriend. I don't even want to hear about it. Only losers get amped up on dudes because of the amount of pussy they get. For real. So I looked at all that to say, you know what, man? Nah. This dude, nah. And like, there's a couple other things he said, like how he's always loved women. I ain't never been a type dude to just love women for who. Just, nah, that shit's whack to me. And, you know, I heard him say something about he couldn't go without sex and all that. Yo, I'm not following people like that. His show does have some things that I can grab some shit from. But I'm not out here in the dating market, so it's really not going to help me. If anything, it's going to allow me to critique past experiences. But then you take a guy like Joker from The Better Bachelor. Low-key, nondescript dude. What's funny is, back when, right before they closed down bars and restaurants, I was at Outback Steakhouse. No, Longhorn Steakhouse. Longhorn Steakhouse. That's the one I like. Not Outback, Longhorn. And there was a guy there that reminded me of Joker. He didn't really look like him. He just reminded me of the dude. And he started a conversation with me by saying, Tom Selleck, there was a commercial at the bar. Tom Selleck had a commercial. And I was looking for something to say to him just like he was looking for something to say to me. I could just tell that that's what the energy was between both of us. So Tom Selleck's on a commercial. And he says, oh, look, Magnum P.I. is still doing stuff. And I said, yeah, did you know that the Indiana Jones role was actually written for Tom Selleck? And it was. So we started having a conversation about that. Then I started talking about how Eddie Murphy should have been the Black Ghostbuster and all that. So we ended up having a conversation. And the guy was from Rising Sun, Maryland. And if you know anything about Rising Sun, it's the KKK capital of the East Coast or some shit like that. Trust me, it's Rising Sun, Maryland. It's got a reputation around here, especially, of being very Klan populated. And I didn't get no energy that dude was a racist or a bigot. I didn't get that energy at all. If I did, I wouldn't have wanted to have a conversation with him. But the point I'm making is, dudes like Joker, I can sit down and have a conversation with at a bar. A guy like Donovan Sharp, I couldn't even relate to him on that type level because he's so off of the broads. And not to mention, you know, Donovan Sharp is a black dude who has said it himself. Niggas ran him off because they didn't think he was black enough. Now, what happened when I was over there on Darrell's platform? They told me, hey, your energy is that of a guy who's been influenced by a lot of white people and we don't want to fuck with you. That's basically what it was. So me and Donovan Sharp are a lot alike in that regard, race and basically black men who most other blacks don't think are black enough to be a part of the struggle. But I still wouldn't converse with him not knowing him like I would someone like Joker. Joker's a nondescript dude who you can tell he's had experiences with women, he has confidence, and he doesn't need growth hormones or whatever, the HGH shit. He doesn't need that to feel like a man. He doesn't need that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm more like a Joker type dude than a off of the broads nigga like Donovan Sharp who wants to conquer women. And that's just, I'm just going to have to accept that my platform is going to attract, hopefully it's going to attract the men that want to be on the Joker side and not want to be on Donovan Sharp's side. Just not want to be over there. Not want to be half and half and somewhat. And that's the thing. He brought Better Bachelor onto his show and people were commenting that, you know, they were there because they saw Joker on his show. And they also said they were basically making it out that your show is better now because you had guys like Joker on there. And he went to his show. No. Them nondescript motherfuckers like us about to take over the world because we're about to have, I don't mean literally speaking, but we're about to have the world is about to conform to our lifestyles, that set routine. Everything Joker talk about, I can relate to that shit, about how everything is routine and men like that routine and women don't. So eventually you're going to have to find a new woman because she's going to get bored. And I like how he said, if you're going to stay in these relationships, you're going to have to constantly up yourself and do better than the last time when it's easier just to start over with somebody else. That's why when I was doing my thing from ages, 16 to 21, I was just, you know, being intimate with them once, twice, maybe three times. And then I was moving on because innately I knew that a long-term relationship was just not something that was going to be feasible to me. But, you know, wrapping it up, I'm saying I only want to fool with certain MGTOW content creators that are MGTOW and truly monk, not the ones that want to claim to be MGTOW because they want to get other dudes that are incels to come buy they fucking Gorilla Mind Rush shit. Donovan Sharp's a clown, man.